previous session we were talking about transistors. So again let us talk about uses of transistors. Transistors basically convert weak signals to strong signals. Okay, they are useful as switches. I would say switches are mechanical type, electronic type. These are electronic switches. The normal switch what you use in your room, you mechanically go there and you switch it on. Okay, those are mechanical switches. These are electronic switches. One more use is they convert DC to AC. Okay, and they also convert radio signals to audio signals and vice versa. They convert audio signals to radio signals. These are the uses of transistors. Okay. The transistor type what we have seen yesterday was NPN. This is also called bipolar junction transistors. So basically these two are a diode and these two are another diode, right? This is PN diode, this is NP diode. Basically transistor is made up of two diodes. Okay, so because there are two junctions are there, at this junction you will find the depletion layer also. Depletion layer you will find at each junction. I told you that for forward biasing, depletion layer DL, depletion layer width, in this case it will be less. For a reverse biasing it will be more. Width means this width. Okay, now the question is you have NPN type, another type is PNP. Okay, which we are going to see now. Can we have PPP or NNN, this type of transistor? Just a layman doubt. See, in when it is an NPN type, this you are calling it as emitter, this as collector, and the middle one is base. Here also the same situation. So if all are P, what will happen? Will the electrons flow? P means what? P type semiconductor, more number of holes. More number of holes is okay, excess of holes, but what about electrons? Okay, all N types, is it possible? So we have only these two types of transistors. Basically you are emitting and this is collecting. Here what it is emitting? It is emitting electrons and the collector is catching electrons. So let us discuss about PNP transistor now. So the diagram for PNP also is similar. This is our PNP transistor. So this is P type, this is N type, and this is p-type. So this is our emitter, base and collector. The middle one is always base. Okay, so this emitter base junction should be forward biasing, and base collector should be reverse biasing, whether it is NPN, whether it is PNP. So this has to be connected in forward bias. Positive, connect to the positive, negative to the negative, anode, cathode. Higher potential, lower potential. This is the collector part, so it should be reverse bias, negative to positive and positive to negative. So this is the circuit diagram. See, unless otherwise you do biasing, we have discussed, if you do biasing, conduction will happen. No biasing, no question of any conduction. Okay, all right. So this is forward bias and this is reverse bias. So here what happens, like in that NPN, this is heavily doped, this is minimum doped, and this is moderately doped. Okay, here what happens when you heavily dope a p-type semiconductors, the holes will increase. Basically positive charges are increasing. Okay, this is kept at minimum doping. I told you in NPN also, if you dope emitter and base both very high, what will happen? The recombination also will be very high. We want to avoid recombination. We don't want recombination. If recombination, you are providing excess number of electrons, you are providing excess number of holes, all those electrons will be occupied by the holes. Then where is conduction? So if the conduction has to happen, one should be heavily doped, another should be minimum doped. Okay, so here also this is heavily doped, more number of holes are there. What is now you have connected this to the positive terminal, higher terminal. What will happen? Positive repulsion, the holes will be projected in this direction. If you see here in the previous class also, I discussed here, there will be an electric field from positive to negative. Remember, see here, there will be a depletion layer, here also a depletion layer will be there. Okay, so because this is forward bias, this depletion layer will be less. This depletion layer, because it is in reverse bias, it will be more. Okay, now in this depletion layer also there is a barrier potential, I told you. Okay, so when you give a forward biasing, you are connecting this to a circuit. Now this potential should be more than the barrier potential, then only the holes will switch on to the other side. There will be mutual movement. Okay, but here the situation is that in p-type there are more number of holes. Okay, so this is more holes, this is more electrons, so electron movement will be in this direction, so the current movement will be in this direction. Current, our sign of convention is, it is opposite to the flow of electrons. Electron movement is in this direction. Conventionally we say that current flow is in this direction. This is the sign convention we follow. Okay, so here this current will be your IE. So this is what it is. So the proton, so the holes have been projected into this, have been moved into this. Some will recombine in this depletion layer, some will recombine, right, and some will cross over. So what is happening basically? So here also, after recombination is happening, there will be a movement of holes. Okay, so here what you have done, here you have reverse biased it. Okay, this is negative terminal here, this is the collector region which is moderately doped. So this positive will be attracted by the negative, and there will be a flow of current in this direction. Okay, if you take a normal circuit, see, like in electricity what we have discussed, you take a normal circuit,
this is negative, this is positive. The flow of electrons is in this direction. So the electrons are moving and coming over here and getting deposited, and this battery is providing you the thrust, so it is going forward. So what is the direction of current here? Direction of current is this. Can I say the current direction is the direction of positive charges? Okay, just for our understanding sake. So this current flow direction will be here also, like in that NPN, 95% will be in this direction and 5% will be in this direction through this wire. Okay, so when it is flowing like this, so here you see the whole movement is like this. So this is your IC and this is your IB. Here we are talking about the positive charges like this. Okay, I am not talking about the electrons. So that is why I have taken the current direction like this. Do not get confused with what we have discussed in the NPN. Okay, I am talking about the movement of the holes here. Nowhere I am bringing into picture the electrons. So this is the system. So here also you can see. So if this is IE, so this is also IE. You can see this is also IC, right? So here also you are getting, apply junction law here, you are getting IE is equal to IB plus IC. Same equation, alright? And here also this is 5%, this is 95%. So you can see that if I make this as an input, it can work as an amplifier. Okay? So this is the representation of working of a PNP type of transistor. Now we will look into the representation with the help of a diagram. So if you want to show it in the form of a diagram, what we do is we draw a circle and this is the notation. This is always the base. Here if I say this is my emitter and this is my collector, the emitter current is towards the junction. I will write like this. Alright. And you can see the base current is away from the junction. So this will be the direction of IB. Alright. And this is the notation. Alright. This is the notation for basic notation to understand ki this is a PNP type. How do you find out whether it's a PNP? So here emitter is moving towards the emitter current is towards the base. So that will help you identify that this is a PNP type. Here I will also draw the NPN. See, for NPN how you are showing? Draw the circle and draw this. So this is base. So let us say this side is collector and this side is emitter. So here what happens? The flow of current is towards the emitter. Okay, if I draw emitter this side, I have to show it like this. Suppose this is NPN type. Okay, so suppose I draw the emitter on the top. Let us say this terminal is emitter and this terminal is collector and this is the base. Okay, so always the flow of current should be towards the emitter. It doesn't matter you write it on the top or on the bottom. I told you that this collector and emitter can be interchanged. It depends upon the level of doping. The quantity of doping will decide which one is emitter and which one is collector. Okay, and this one, this is PNP. Remember, here the flow of current is towards the junction. Here it is, see, emitter current is towards the junction and here it is away from the junction. If you call this as a junction, it is away from the junction, it is towards the junction. Now let us just briefly discuss how transistor acts like a switch. I told you that this is a electronic switch, unlike your mechanical switches. So this is the schematic diagram. So here you can see this is the
a loop which is carrying the main current. Here main battery is connected, and you can see this is the transistor part. So here you can see the flow of current is towards the emitter. It is a NPN type of transistor. And this portion here, you have to imagine there is a battery. So this is the signal current. So this circuit, what will happen is, from base to emitter, if it creates a potential difference, if it creates, see, if it is a for semiconductor, I told you it should be 0.6 to 0.7 electron volts of potential difference has to be created. So it is like this. When you create this much of potential difference, so the main current is going like this, it will flow. Okay, so this is your base and emitter region. So when this much amount of potential you provide, this there will be a flow of current over here. Remember, the current flow from the base to the emitter is very small. The main current is collector to emitter. Okay, collector to emitter is the main current part. So the potential drop from collector to emitter is called VCE. It is denoted like this. VCE means potential drop between the collector and the emitter. VBE means potential drop from base to the emitter. Okay, when the potential drop from the base to emitter is of the order this much for silicon, what will happen? The switch will open and the main current, this is the main current, this is the loop, the main current will flow from collector to emitter. Remember that 95% current part we were talking about, it will happen like this. So this is the schematic diagram. Suppose the potential difference is not of this order, it will disconnect. So this is how it acts like a switch. Here a particular example I have shown. You have connected here a 9 volt battery, okay, and you have connected a LED light also. So now this is the diagram. Here the flow of current is towards the emitter, so it is NPN type. Okay, so suppose you connect here a battery, you have to imagine there is a battery over here, and you create a potential difference between the base and the emitter. What will happen? The circuit will be connected. Okay, so total voltage was 9 volts, and here you see this is the path. So this is the path. So from B to A, there is a drop of 0.6 to 0.7 electron volts. So what will be the total potential difference now? 9 minus 0.7, it is 8.3 volts. Okay, suppose this potential drop is not 0.6 electron volts, but 0.4 electron volts. Okay, let us say the drop between the base to the emitter is 0.4 electron volts. Now will the circuit be connected? Will the current flow? The current won't flow. Okay, so in this diagram I have shown some resistors. You see, I have shown some resistors. So the same, see, basically what you have to do, you have to create a potential drop between the base and the emitter. Either you do it with the battery, or if you don't have a battery, you can take from some other source. What will this resistor do? It will ensure that there is a potential drop. V is equal to IR. V is equal to IR is there, no formula. What does this ensure? It is dropping potential, right? It is dropping potential. A wire is there, you introduce a resistor. Here there is 10 volts. Now because of this resistor, it will fall to 5 volts. Our purpose is that only. So in the practical purpose, what we do is we put a resistor over here, like shown in this diagram. Okay. Or if you can imagine just a battery over there, and the battery is providing that necessary potential difference. If I consider these two points, I can write VBE, the potential drop between the base and the emitter. If I consider these two parts, it will be VBC, the potential drop between the base and the collector. So this is how a transistor acts like a switch. So you can see here, this collector part is connected to, the collector part is connected to the base, which is at a higher potential. In NPN, what happens? This collector is connected to the base terminal, which is at a higher potential. In PNP,
it is connected to the negative terminal. PNP also similar procedure is there, but what you need to understand is collector to base should be positive in case of NPN and collector to base should be negative in PNP. This is another diagram I have drawn to explain in detail. Same diagram I have drawn. So this is VCC, this is the main potential now. So potential across collector. So this is VBB, potential across base. And this collector wire will have some resistance denoted by RC. So this central portion is your transistor part. This is your emitter. No need to say that this is base, this is emitter, and this is the collector part. Current flowing from base to emitter, so it is NPN type. Okay, this is that wire we are using, so it will have some resistance in the base, the RB. This wire will have some resistance, RE. If you pick these two points near the base, near the emitter, there will be a potential drop, VBE. You can see positive, negative, positive to negative it should be. Then only the current will flow, the circuit will be connected. This VBE should be greater than or equal to 0.6 electron volts for semiconductors. 0.6 you can say, 0.7 you can say. So pick a point on near the base, pick a point near the collector. The potential drop is called VCE. You can see here positive to negative, collector is on the higher potential, base is on the lower potential. Okay. See, the main current is ICE only. This we have discussed that this is approximately 95%. IBE is the minor current. It's only 5% we have told. Okay. So because IBE is a lower, this you can use as an input current. This can be an output current. Okay. So that's how you amplify. Amplification we'll see in detail in coming sessions. So the base is at a higher potential compared with this. When the potential difference matches this, there will be a current flow. The switch will act. So this is also a detailed diagram. So you should note these terms. Here you can put a battery, or you can connect this to some source and use proper resistors here and ensure that this much potential drop is available. So let us say if switch on condition, you take 0.9 volts, 0.4 volts, 0.65, 0.8 volts, electron, all values in electron volts. So here I will write on off. 0.9 more than this, switch is on condition. 0.4 off condition. 0.65 on condition. 0.8 on condition. This is how electronically it is controlled. Okay, so this is how a transistor is used as a switch. So this is the detailed diagram. This diagram you should make a note of, and you should remember the pattern, how the things are happening. The main current will flow from this terminal to this terminal only. You can see here, if the current has to flow from collector to the emitter, which potential should be high? Collector potential should be high. And you can see that this is earthed. What is earthing? Potential is equal to zero. If you put 10 volts here, this is 0 volt, which is at a higher potential. This is at a higher potential. Okay. So this is the manner in which a transistor is used as a switch. Any question comes on this, you should be able to draw this diagram and explain all the points what I have explained over here.